States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. We do roll call one, please.
Yes. Mrs. Byrne.
Present.
Mrs. Cerucci.
Here.
Mr. Lapsovich.
Here.
Mr. Nola.
Here.
Mr. O'Donnell.
Here.
Mr. Ritter.
John is here.
Mr. Steubenbort.
Here.
Mrs. Warning.
Here.
Mr. Williams.
Here.
Very good. We have a slight change to the agenda. Before we move on to comments from residents on agenda items, we will actually have a presentation by Joy Mattis and Troy Yolowitz and their students. So I will pass it on to Joy.
I'd like to introduce myself. My name is Joy Mattis, and I am the sixth grade science teacher and the sixth grade STEAM coordinator for our district.
Hold that microphone over for help.
Sorry about that. And behind the scenes, we're having a little bit of video issues. Our video is playing, but there's no sound to it, which is kind of an issue. But the reason I'm here today is Mr. Short invited us to come and speak with you today. I brought with me Mr. Yolowitz and Kylie Edwards. She's currently a seventh grade student at Gateway Middle School, and Perry Moftolo, and she's also a seventh grade student at the Gateway Middle School. On Tuesday, we were invited to speak at the STEAM conference, and this was a really big honor for us because we were chosen out of tons of schools that applied for a STEAM grant. We were actually offered $20,000 to implement our STEAM grant over the course of the year, and then 28 schools were supposed to come and present their program. We got a call 2 weeks before our program was to be presented and said that they want to highlight our school because they felt like we did such a great job in such a diverse district, getting our program across, and they were really impressed with the kind of accomplishments that our students had. And so that's why we were chosen, and we had four very eloquent speakers, and you got me. I wasn't presenting there, so I'm presenting here. So I apologize. I am a teacher, and I speak in front of people all the time, but speaking in front of adults is a little bit nerve-wracking, so please stay with me. I'd appreciate it. So Mr. Short asked us to talk about how this program evolved, and that was kind of a tricky question. It has been in place for many, many years. We've been providing our students with STEAM activities for many years. They've done it in Mr. Yulowitz's class. He's our technology specialist. They've been doing it in Mr. Yulowitz's class, or Mr. Kunkel's class. He is our gifted coordinator. And they've been doing it in science class. But until we had the opportunity in 2016 to visit other schools and find out what they were providing their students, we did not have a collaborative group effort within our school. We found that when we visited schools, then they were showing off the best of the best. We realized we had the best of the best. We just didn't have organization, and we were missing a couple key components. When the 2016 STEAM grant was brought to our attention, we immediately applied. With that grant, we got 12 laptop computers. We got a drone. We were supposed to get a 3D printer, but our PTO was nice enough to buy it for us. So we used it to buy more filament. We bought something called Little Bits, some things called Makey Makeys that Mr. Short asked us to display here. And we started our process. I would like to say that we had a really clear idea of where we were going with this program. We laid it all out. We had it ready to go. And then sometimes our students took us in a different direction. We empowered them so much that they felt like we could do anything that they brought to our attention, which was great. When we went to SciTech Days, which is down at Carnegie Science Center, they're able to take different classes, and they came back to us the first time they went, and they said, we want a 3D print at our school. Like, okay, well, I'll try to learn how to 3D print at our school. So we got the 3D printer, and now they're 3D printing at our school. Then the next year, they came back and said, well, we want GameStar mechanics. We want to design our own video games. So now our kids design their own video games, and they design their own gaming controllers. We've been lucky enough to make so many partners over the years. We have, just to name a few, we have financial support from this grant with the Chevron Foundation, the Benedict Foundation, the Grable Foundation, Massey Middle School, FTO, the Society for Analytical Chemists of Pittsburgh, McDonald's, PPG, Lowe's, and Pacatans. We have educational supporters like the California University of Pennsylvania, Citizens Power, Alcosan, Carnegie STEAM Pathways, and RiverQuest Outreach. So we've been able, where we say, you know, we are a team at Mosside Middle School, our team really is extending way beyond our school walls. So we, that's pretty much what I wanted to present, because we actually had a video that I'm not sure if it's working now that outlines our STEAM program. Mr. Ulois, is it going to work? He's working on it.
If I could just jump in, I had the pleasure of attending the STEAM Showcase. That's a yearly event sponsored by the Allegheny Intermediate Unit. And upon entering, if you can imagine, a ballroom filled with different booths set up around the perimeter, and it's just educators from not only Allegheny County, Westmoreland County, Fayette County, all of Western Pennsylvania. And the fascinating part was seeing our students and our staff right there pretty much in the center, and having repeat administrators bringing back other administrators, teachers, to showcase and to have our students highlight their accomplishments. So just sitting back, you know, watching all that take place made me very proud. And of course, the presentation by the young ladies, phenomenal. So I turned it back.
That's a great lead-in. Yeah. We're actually going to hope the video is working once they speak, but I'm going to ask Kylie Edwards to go ahead and come up. And these two girls are the best of the best. We have a lot of wonderful kids at Gateway, but they represent us so well, and we are so proud of them. So we'll get Kylie.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Kylie Edwards, and I'm a seventh grader in the Gateway School District. I'm here to talk to you about how STEAM has impacted me. We are very fortunate to have our own STEAM lab at Mosside Middle School, where teachers can conduct classes to build our knowledge on STEAM. The razor-sharp minds of our student body can harness this information and turn it into ideas. For example, one of our assignments in science class was to recreate a music video about the parts of both an animal and plant cell. We utilized our green screen to create backgrounds that we don't have access to. We used our engineering skills to construct props that would increase the visual enjoyment of our audience. iMovie, the computer software that we used, aided us in creating awesome edits for said video. This example shows that just one topic in STEAM incorporates many more. Again, we took advantage of our technological savvy to become graphic designers. A challenge was presented to create our own pet care store. We used Adobe Illustrator to create our logos, business cards, and other needed print material. We became business managers as we created menus and learned to budget expenses. We then took our ideas to a computer fair where we competed against other schools. This project gave our future graphic designers and business managers at Gateway the experience that will help them in their field. In doing these activities, I have been given the tools to pursue various careers. Currently, I am a news anchor on the daily news at Gateway Middle School. Further down the line, I would like to be an actress on Broadway and the big screen. By stretching my imagination and helping me to remove the limits of my creativity, STEAM has helped me prepare for both.
Awesome. We're going to call Perry, but before we do, they wrote these speeches themselves. And that's one of the things when we were sitting down with them, we're like, geez, you might want to try to dumb this down a little bit, because no one's going to believe you wrote it down. Like, they do such a good job. They did a better job, I swear, speaking to Mr. Kunkel and myself. But Perry's next. She wrote her speech as well. Kylie, all her ideas, they came up. When we said they were going to present, you know, less than 2 weeks, they put it together, and that's the type of kids they are. So good, Perry, no pressure.
Hello, everyone. My name is Perry Muftolo, and I attend the 7th grade in the Gateway School District. Thank you for joining me as I inform you all about STEAM at Gateway's Mosside Middle School. Energy balances our lives, but the fossil fuels we use today create dangerous side effects towards the Earth. So without new ideas to convert our everyday needed energy, we will have nothing left. Luckily, over the years, people have developed renewable and alternative ways to convert power. The Mosside Middle School STEAM program inspired our future engineers and problem solvers that will discover new, simple, and inexpensive ways to convert energy. In class, we deeply discussed the advantages and disadvantages of each source, and later took a much higher step by testing and observing them in different projects. First, we brought our solar panel testing kit around the school on a predicted sunny day and watched as a light bulb attached to the kit lit up. Later on, we used another miniature demonstration, but instead with wind energy. We enjoyed the class outside as we competed to find where the most powerful winds ripped through. Having the opportunity to learn about power while pursuing a hands-on activity brought a much closer understanding to us. STEAM's main project on energy dealt with high-level, out-of-the-box thinking when the project assignment asked us to construct a wind turbine's blades. The goal required my classmates and me to measure the highest wind speeds caught on the blade with the help of a fan. At the end of the assignment, the teams had one chance to showcase their wind turbines in front of the class. It was a great educational competition that required concentration and a deep understanding about how wind turbines operated. The Mossad Middle School takes pride in teaching us about STEAM and all the subjects that contribute to it. We love and appreciate our STEAM program and are now building off into more experiments that have been inspired by the program. STEAM is so important in any field that we will work for in the future, and it was great that we were introduced to it early. I am extremely grateful that I had the opportunity to explore these different projects and energy sources. Thank you for your time and attention. The Gateway Mossad Middle School STEAM program truly helps shape our future.
Well, our technical difficulties have not been fixed. So we will make sure that we email you the STEAM video that we were going to show. And also, if you are interested in keeping up to date on what kind of STEAM activities we're doing in our classroom, on the new school website, if you type in Joy Mattis under Mossad, or look up Joy Mattis under Mossad Middle School, it has our STEAM video on it. If you want to share what the girls shared today, it has their video on there. Surprise, girls. And it has our science, how we integrate STEAM into our regular science program. And there's also this really, really cute video of the kids using Makey Makeys. Oh, you might still have hope. Okay, while they try to create more hope.
Why don't you tell us what's on that cart?
That's what I was going for. Thank you, Mr. G. Okay, so on our cart, we have our Makey Makeys. It's part of our STEAM program. And what the kids do is, in some classes, well, first of all, they learn how to use a Makey Makey. And a Makey Makey is this little panel here. And this little panel works as a controller. So they have to find out what material is conductive, which ones are semiconductive, and which ones are insulators. And they make their own gaming controller. Now there's extension activities that go with it, which really makes us hit a broader spectrum of our students. Some students have chosen to interview the special ed teachers, or that we now have a preschool program in our school, so they interview the preschool students' teachers and find out what skills they're working on. They also find out, since we know that some students who are life skills and autistic students have certain tactile issues, they find out what kind of materials they like to use, what kind of skills they're working on, and how best to meet their needs. Then they go in and they make a Scratch program or an Alice program, and they actually design their own learning program for these kids. And then they try it out with the kids, go back, make adaptations, and then present it again. So it really gives them a sense of ownership and accomplishment and purpose, because they're able to design something that little kids love. These little kids love, and the life skill kids, they're overwhelmed sometimes with this keyboard and the fact that they can only press four buttons and be able to manipulate the computer is really, really interesting to them. So I just brought some stuff, like we use Play-Doh, potatoes of all things. This one's set up to use water. You can use leaves, basically anything that has some type of moisture to it or metal to it. Some of our kids, and I don't want to tell you too much about it because it's a surprise, but some of our kids decided they were going to make instruments. So we have some instruments in the making. This student, I explained it to him, and a couple days later he came in with this. So these kids are giving themselves homework. They're giving themselves homework, which is crazy. And so they're just excited and they're ready to go. And if you check out the webpage, there's a video showing how excited they are. So that's a good sign. And then this student, he said, I can bring it as long as I make sure I tell everybody that it's in the making and it's not finished. So when Mrs. Spean, our music teacher, got a hold of the fact that we have a guitar now in the making, and we have a drum set in the making, her mind started going. So there's going to be some Miss Spina makey stuff going on in the future, I think. So hopefully you'll be able to experience that a little bit more, maybe in a concert or some sort in the future. So does anybody have any questions about what we do in STEAM or the makey-makeys? I don't want to dominate too much of your time, but.
Are we ready for the video?
I'm hoping. Are we ready for the video?
It's not gonna be real loud, so just listen quietly. You're much better than the students.
At Lewis High Middle School, we are all about STEAM. We use our STEAM labs and resources to work as young scientists, engineers, designers, programmers,
the list goes on.
The resources, materials, and spaces help us develop lifelong skills that have enabled us to compete in the 21st century, where STEAM skills are essential for nearly every career.
We apply STEAM in all of our subjects. For example, in social studies, we build creative videos in the STEAM lab that focus on post-Cold War and current events.
We use our STEAM labs in science to discover, diagram, and create models of plant and animal cells, organelles, and their functions.
Instead of playing games, we become game designers by using GameStar Mechanics, Scratch, and Alice to program and design working video games.
We use our STEAM skills to design, create, test, reevaluate, and redesign wind turbines. It was fun to challenge ourselves to design a wind turbine that converts the most energy.
We create things at Mosside, not just consume things.
At Mosside, we act as salespeople or business owners as we use Keynote and PowerPoint, which are both used in the business world, to create presentations to convey information to a variety of audiences.
Through our presentations, we learn that this software can assist us as we present an idea to an audience and that it can help us be more effective speakers.
We integrate charts, graphs, and graphic organizers into our presentations using Microsoft Excel. This software helps us organize our information and display it for others.
At Mosside, we are graphic designers and artists as we design our own magazine covers and digital collages.
We learn to think critically about how to lay out and how to manipulate layers, images, and text.
We become podcasters with this software as we make educational podcasts that teach other students about cyber safety.
We are engineers and design teams when we use CAD software to create and build our very own models that can be printed on our 3D printer.
We become geologists when we design and create models that represent Earth's changing surfaces.
We are newscasters and news crew when we write, record, edit, and publish daily newscasts on our website.
This helps us understand the importance of the varieties of roles in the news organization and how technology can help you communicate with the world.
That's right. We are helping shape the world.
At Mosside, we harness emerging technologies.
We have a school drone that we use to capture aerial footage of our school for the news and discuss how this technology can be utilized and how future careers will be built around this cutting-edge resource.
We use iMovie and our STEAM lab to create resources for our building and others.
An example is when our sixth grade students created a fourth grade orientation video for the students in their four elementary buildings.
We become meteorologists to analyze local weather through the school WeatherNet program.
Our STEAM lab was an essential place to make our World War I video journals and paper look old for our journals by experimenting with various substances to make our papers look older than they actually were.
We are web content creators. Instead of relying on con videos and YouTubes, the teachers and the students at Mosside Middle School create their own screen recording videos to summarize the activities and provide a place for students to review the activities and knowledge acquired from each unit. Our students could use these recordings to help them learn more efficiently.
As scientists, we design and conduct experiments to compare the various types of energy and how they work.
We determine the positives and negatives of each type of alternative energy.
At Mosside, we program. We combine our math and art skills with technology to design our very own world that resembles some of the video games that we play.
All of our students, including our autistic learners, experiment with makey-makeys to learn about how various objects can be used to input commands into technology
become robotic engineers at Mosside by using Mindstorms to create, program, and test robots.
We are public speakers and communicators. During our open house, parents and community members observed and participated in STEAM activities in our STEAM labs.
At Mosside, STEAM is not something that we are doing because it is the latest buzzword or idea.
STEAM is our future!
One more short video, it's only a couple seconds, just to show why we do what we do. There's been a lot of people asking for us to send videos and pictures throughout, and very seldom do I get the chance to experience that aha moment and capture it on tape. Well, I get to experience a lot, but I don't often get to catch it on tape. So I just want to show you a couple seconds. And in this picture, or in this video, they really don't know why what's happening is happening. And that's the best part, because you know they're going to work hard with the excitement in their voice to figure out why it did what it did. So there's a lot of learning behind the questions that they're presented. It's the one in the whole pot at the bottom. It's that one right there. Wanted to figure out who was controlling that. So there was a lot of work that came out of the not knowing. So I appreciate you taking the time to listen to us today. It's been a great experience and a great ride, and we can't even comprehend what we're going to encounter in the next couple of years as we're building and growing our program.
Are they all your students?
Well, he teaches every student in the entire building. He has fifth and sixth grade. I teach sixth grade, and I teach Team B in sixth grade, so I do the integrated STEAM program within just those four or five classrooms. And then I have STEAM, which is at the end of the day, and I have half a semester, I have Team B, and the other half of the semester, one semester I have Team B, and then the other semester I have Team A. So it would be nice to be able to move forward and build the program. And we're meeting with the STEAM partnership, and we invited the school board. I hope you got the invitation to meet with Dana Winthrobel on the 20th of October. So Mr. Ulowitz and I will be there on the 20th and kind of sit down and see how we can branch this out to more kids.
They're great ambassadors.
Yes.
They are. They're fantastic.
Absolutely super. All of the young folks.
Yes.
Not only the STEAM, I mean, you guys are so well-spoken. I was actually taken aback.
That's
a very hard spell to
So we're checking to see if you're really in middle school.
Yes. You can look them up in Skyward. They actually go to school here. So we're very lucky to have people, that have kids that just...
I get kids all the time from all over, and I'm always asking, what are you doing in computer class? From neighboring districts all over. My own kids go to Greater Latrobe. They don't even have elementary computer class till 7th grade. And I'm just like, they're missing the boat a little bit. Like, our kids are getting it in 5th grade, and they're starting, and we're diving right into these projects. And a lot of people think I have the easiest job in the world, because they're like, these students know everything, you know? Oh my, they're really good. But the truth of the matter is, they're really good at like social media. They're really good at playing video games. They're not so good at creating their own content for educational purposes or for lifelong purposes. And that's kind of the focus in my room. So I'm very proud. That was too gross.
You're getting a little choked up.
You see and you understand why Gateway was chosen out of all the districts through the intermediate unit to have our young ladies present and their mentors, their teachers did an incredible job.
I have to say something. I was fortunate enough to sit in on their classes. I had a student when I was working at Mosside Middle in both of their classes, and they're such awesome teachers. I mean, all the students are just so engrossed in what they're teaching, and I have to applaud you guys. You do a fantastic job.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good job. Thank you.
And also, you guys may not know, that's a reporter next to you, so you might want to talk to her and get a story.
I have pictures for you.
Positive stories. Thank you very much, that was awesome.
Okay, I'd like to make a motion that the board recess into executive session for personnel reasons.
We have a motion. We have a second.
Second.
Do you want the public to speak first?
No, there's a motion. There's a second.
He wanted it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Seeing none, we'll move into executive session. Hopefully, this will not be as long as others. We'll move right along, and we will start with comments from residents on agenda items. Do we have anyone sign up in advance?
Not in advance, no.
Okay, so we have anyone that would like to address us on agenda items. Seeing none, we'll move on to Section B, Bills and Financial Reports. Mr. Shaw.
Thank you, Mr. Steven Board. Section B actually will be presenting at the next meeting. Specifically, we will have the list of bills for October 2016, the monthly financial statements for September 2016, and for the first time for the fiscal year, any applicable budget transfers for the fiscal year. But again, those will be presented at the regular meeting.
Very good, thank you. Any questions or comments, sir? Seeing none, we'll move on to Section C, items previously tabled. We have none. We'll move on to Section D, personnel, and we will actually start with, we have one action item under Section D. Mrs. Crump, if you could, the action item.
Yes, Mr. Stupenport. Resolved that the Gateway Board of School Directors accepts and approves the personnel agenda as listed in Section D for the study session meeting of Tuesday, October 4th, 2016. We are recommending employment of two school police officers, William Katner and Steven Saranovich.
So moved.
Second.
So motion second. Any questions or comments?
Can I just ask, how many does that take us up to now?
13.
Okay. Any other further questions or comments? Seeing none, roll call, Bonnie, please.
Mrs. Cerucci.
Aye.
Mr. Lapsevich.
Aye.
Mr. Nola.
Aye.
Mr. O'Donnell.
Aye.
Mr. Ritter.
Aye.
Mr. Steubenbort.
Aye.
Mrs. Warning.
Aye.
Mr. Williams.
No.
Mrs. Byrne.
No.
Good. Motion passes 7-2. We'll move on to Section D, personnel agenda, non-action item.
Yes, we have several listings for next week on the agenda. We have a resignation. Transfers per the collective bargaining agreement. We have three leaves of absences. We also are going to be recommending four teachers for tenure. For those of you that are new to the board, a teacher must teach in a district for 3 years of service, have satisfactory evaluations, and also go through an induction. So the four teachers that we have listed have met all of those accomplishments, and so they will be recommended for tenure. We have supplemental contracts listed, volunteers, and further discussion from last month, we did some investigation on substitute rates, and it is the administration's recommendation that we do raise the substitute rate for our custodian, secretaries, food service, and teacher's aides. If you will remember, in August, we did raise the teachers up from 90 to 110.
Will there have to be an MOU, or how will that work?
As far as the custodians, I've talked to Mr. Winters, and we just have to give him some information, and they will add it as an MOU to it. As he says, they have no problem paying them more.
I had a question about item B on Don Hole, the third. Is he related to our...
He is. He's a little
bit of a... Yes, we're not having that. Apologize for that. Good catch.
So he is...
He is the son.
Correct.
And that is a reassignment, but yes. Or treasure.
Yes. Yes. He was already on one position. This is from the
other governors on.
I just generally have just reservations about hiring so much from within. I hear you, and I don't disagree with. I mean, I see it. I'm just raising it.
Any other questions or comments?
Does he have experience? Does he?
Yeah, he graduated college and he played college football. And from what I hear, he's a good job. He's on staff.
He was already recruited in another position.
He's already on staff.
He's just being reassigned.
Not really a new hire.
All right, so that would have helped me.
Any other questions or comments under Section D?
Can I just make a suggestion from in the future? Is it possible that we can do each section, like Section 1, Section 2, that Bonnie could do individual, that we can do it so we're voting on each one separately?
At the regular school board meeting?
Correct.
If there's one that you want to pull out separately, just mention it and we will. The problem is in some of these, if there's like 20 doing a roll call vote, if there's no different, you know, if no one has any objections, because I know they did that previously. I think Steve, when you were on the board, somebody made that suggestion. It really elongated the meeting.
Okay.
But at any point, I mean, we've done that several times recently. If anyone wants to pull something out separately.
I think what arose is that you know, there are occasions when there's so many items in there that we as board members, and you can criticize us, miss it. And it just feels like they get jumbled together.
Sometimes when we list items 1 through 16 and we ask for a vote on it.
Yeah. I mean, you know, because I missed one last time I corrected that.
Yeah, I see. I would recommend, I mean, unless you guys want to, I just know that it has been done previously. I think it lasted for a meeting or two, and then they realized, and Bonnie, you could attest to that as well, that it takes a while to do a roll call vote on some of these when you have.
I don't know what the solution is. I don't think we want to go to 16 separate motions on.
But you can go, you can say, I to everything except for
Neil.
Number 6B.
Yeah, I mean, we know, I'm with you on that. I'm just. I'm just saying
when you have so much that, you know, you come to it and it's already passed.
I don't know how.
Well, yeah, I would say, I mean, especially if we're going through the study session and then it's on there again, so you'll have weeks, if not over a month, to look. That would be my only recommendation other than.
Neil's right. I mean, we can pull.
Or you can just pull it out if you want to say just vote that separately. But. You could just say yes or no to anyone you want, actually.
Maybe what about quickly, a session at a time?
Quickly review each other.
But that's what the study sessions technically
are. Some are added, Neil, you know yourself, some are added after the study session.
That's an issue. That's why we don't like that happening.
Right.
That's why we don't like them happening after the study session, or even in board reports. We don't like things added when it's not in here.
So I would make a recommendation just to review them prior to, just because it would really lengthen meetings and unnecessarily so.
Well, I don't mind staying. I don't know about anybody else, but okay.
I think we had some complaints from the public on our last meeting's length. So.
Well, okay.
Anything else under Section D? Any other questions or comments? Seeing none, we'll move on to Section E, which we actually did a breakout one to add conferences and conventions separately to help with some of the confusion there. And I will pass that on to Mr. Short.
Thank you, Mr. Stewart. We do have Section E added, conferences and conventions for the board's review. We have a number of our school police officers going to the basic SRO training to be held at Quaker Valley Middle School. You see 5 individuals from our police operational force who will receive training. We also have on the next page Angela Dietrich attending the conference for dyslexia, and also Mr. Crestar. This is an annual media coordinators meeting in Hempstead.
Two
two questions I have. The first one, why is there a price discrepancy between the one?
Mileage. Mileage. The $495 was the base amount for the training.
And one submitted for mileage.
Yes, she'll be doing the driving.
Okay.
Oh, she's doing driving
for all.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and that's based off the IRS, like everything else.
Yes, exactly.
So after these ones, will you send another group then, so they all will be trained then?
Yes,
that's the plan.
Okay.
And actually, we may actually get a discount because we sent five at a time for
okay.
this one.
I think this is part and parcel of your committee's commitment to continue to train as this program evolves.
I remember the one recommendation was not to have everyone at once,
yeah.
so that
I like to give
they don't all come
right.
up.
I'm more training. Okay. But I mean, it is. But it was raised last meeting, and we made it pretty clear
yes.
that they're committed to that.
Yeah.
This is
yes.
an example of it.
Yeah, and Mr. Scoob gets credit for that. I mean, he actually arranged a special training just for the Gateway School Police, as far as I'm aware, to have it done
Great.
Earlier. They were going to wait until Christmas break.
And that's how we got the discount. If we supplied them by five, so that way they could have at least a half of a class, they would do it for us earlier.
Very good. The only other question I have is on the second one, one's going to Homestead, one's going to Florida. So, feel bad for one going to Homestead versus one going to Florida.
for about the same amount of money.
Yeah. any other questions or
Probably
comments?
Going to Homestead is walking, I think.
Maybe that's a call. It is Homestead. Yeah.
Any other questions or comments under conferences or conventions? All right. Seeing none, we'll move on to Section F, Administrative Resolutions. Mr. Short.
Thank you. I'm going to refer for Mr. Short to cover items 1 through 3. I will take item number 4.
Thank you, Mr. Short. Item number 1, administration is seeking approval to advertise or request for proposal for a new district phone system, phone service, and redundant internet service. The intent with this would be to be able to move forward, analyze RFPs from various vendors, and to get a phone system identified and budget for it in the 17-18 budget for that.
A comment on that, you know, I've again been consistent on this. I think that when this, I actually think it ought to be pulled off the agenda. We're not prepared for it, our department's not prepared for it. I understand it's an RFP, but I think it ought to be put back until the following year. So,
well, it is going to be for the following year.
Well,
yeah, we're just
the RFP piece,
but then you wouldn't be able to do it before the next school year.
Mike, if you want to talk to this,
yeah. Well, you know what? We've had this discussion.
No, I think there's some
we
new information about this
okay.
phone company that Mike needs to share with us.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, the RFP, just to let you know, it's going to go out for a full 60 days, which is longer than the average RFP, just because for running a new internet circuit or phone service, vendors need extra time to come in, evaluate the site, and see how to actually get the lines into the building. So we need to make sure we allocate enough time for them to come in, review it. Then once they come back with a proposal, it'll take us about a month to review it. And then even then, that's going to take us pretty close into the next school year as far as implementing it. So we won't be implementing this until the summer.
And this is Micah's recommendation, correct?
Yes.
The RFP. Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm actually opposed. I wanted the other way along with Paul and Bill, but this was, and can you also touch on the savings that you had brought up?
Yeah, so the goal for this is by waiting to the summer, we'll be able to consolidate services for both internet and for phone service. Many phone vendors, since the phone systems will come into the district over VoIP, which is essentially over the internet, we might be able to include internet service at a very low cost. So instead of paying two different vendors one amount, we can combine them and reduce it overall.
Micah, didn't you mention also, I think in our conversation talking, if we would go with this right now, it's going to cost us in the long run with the service agreement down the road with the new company? Was there something?
Well, there's no company involved in this yet. So this is just basically we're going to go
right.
out.
Right. If we would have not advertised, if we would have stayed with the company that was recommended.
And you're asking about the service for that? Well, so... I think I see what you're saying. So the way we would have to structure our phone service right now is we would have to use our existing phone service to get us through until the summer, and then we would have to renegotiate. Once we get to that point, because the phone system's already been purchased, we may have to get additional hardware or additional software licenses to convert to a new service. So there could be potential costs by using the phone system that was proposed at the last meeting. There still would be a net savings, but it won't be as much as if we consolidated everything up front.
So your recommendation, just going with that, is to get an RFP, get requests for proposals, to see who can bundle with them and see if there's more of a savings than what we were going to vote on last time.
Yes.
And that would not happen until next school year.
Yes, and I expect the phone system itself will be about the same as we discussed.
Do you think
it's
the
services, yes, low. That we can save.
Are we still paying monthly our current provider with no contract?
It's not monthly, actually annual. Yeah. We've only made, this is our third year, we've only received
two invoices. To allow us to pay up to January in preparation for potentially switching. We have not received a bill from them yet.
Okay.
It's good company.
Good.
Yeah.
Well, if they continue to give us free services, I would recommend
this. If they keep giving us free service, I say we stay with them as long as possible.
It's a shame we weren't earning any extra money on that this fund since we're holding them, since interest rate is so low. So. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Any other questions on that one? Item number two.
Yep. Item number two, administration will be seeking approval of a service agreement for medical waste disposal services with Stericycle, as depicted in Exhibit A. And item number three, administration will be seeking approval of a disposal service agreement with Shred-It for additional services required during 16-17. We're actually going to like to bring them back one more time. We've identified some other items that were missed in the previous shred that occurred in July, so this would just enable us to basically dispose of additional items.
Is there a cost associated with that?
Oh, yes. As per the item, minimum cost of $200. I think we were estimating just a number of banker's boxes, that I think it's $6.
Okay.
I'm not sure of the exact quantity, but what we're actually going to do is send an email out and see if any other buildings have additional items too.
I know, without a cost, I didn't want to approve them.
Yeah, I just set it up with the rates on there, so it'll apply to the rates. Item number four, administration is seeking approval of two donations received, one from Westmoreland Hospital for Dr. Cleveland Stewart Jr. Elementary School in amount of $1,000. Second donation from Phipps Conservatory Champion Schools Grant, also to Dr. Cleveland Stewart Jr. Elementary School for $1,000.
What are they for? What nominated?
They applied for various grants. For the first one, nominated by Suzanne Dzwonik, and applied to Westmoreland Hospital, and
for what? I do not know.
On the general purposes. Suzanne Dzwonik is our reading teacher, ELA, so it could be resources to help either with tutoring or
specifically go to Cleveland Stewart to track that. It goes to that.
It goes to that. Yes. Yeah, we inform them of that. We get it approved, and it gives them some additional resources utilized through the fiscal year. Item number five, administration seeking approval of the following overnight excursions for the marching band, St. Patrick's Day Parade in Boston, Scholastic Winter Guard, Dayton, Ohio.
The marching band one, is that 662, is that district cost, or is it says person family fundraising, is that just allowing them to go?
We may have to look at that.
Yeah, I haven't seen it.
Okay. Either way, I think that's an awesome opportunity to get to Boston for the St. Patrick's.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Yeah, if they need chaperones, let me know.
What?
Either way, I'm really not too concerned, but I just want to look at.
Yeah, we should. What's the Scholastic Winter Guard?
660. It's Keller Guard.
That's
it's marching band.
Okay, it's another picture.
Yes.
Okay.
They do supplemental work in the winter. Typically, they have
competitions. Who pays for that?
Boosters.
Yeah. Boosters.
Self-funded.
They all have chaperones. Yes.
Right. So if we could just see clarity on that before next.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Next item,
Mr. Shaw. Item number six, a motion authorizing the selection of ABM Building Solutions after receiving proposals for an energy services contract under Pennsylvania Act 39, 2010, as depicted.
And this is gathering more information?
Correct. Utilizing them to drill down deeper into some of those costs that we had discussed earlier in the building and grounds meeting.
Are we committing money for this?
That's my question, gentlemen.
Since you're there.
For what and how much?
So there's an investor grade audit fee. I don't know if we have any RFP at this point. But
say that again. There's a what?
Investment grade analysis fee.
Investment grade analysis fee.
So if we can develop a self-funded solution.
If you don't mind going to the
microphone. Sure. So if we can develop a self-funded solution, which the energy and operational savings pays for the program, and the district moves forward with the program in some capacity, then the fee is rolled into the project. And if we cannot develop a self-funded solution using energy and operational savings, then there's no district fee at all.
When you say some capacity, that means
we may engineer. We may engineer $4 or $5 million, and the district decides to do $1 million worth of self-funded improvements.
So the fee for in your example would be what?
In the example that I shared with you, if you move forward with a program, then the fee's rolled into the project. And if we can't develop a solution, right, then there's no fee at all.
So if we replace one of the HVAC units, we wouldn't have a fee?
Correct. It's essentially, right, if it was self-funded, there would be a fee associated with the project.
So at the end of the day, you're going to choose the scope that the school wants, and if a scope is chosen, the fee would get rolled into it.
So how much is the fee?
Currently, we estimated about $50,000 to develop the self-funded solution.
So if you do all the work, we don't do anything, we owe you $50,000.
Correct.
If we replace one of the HVAC units, we don't owe you a dime.
Correct.
So this is obligating us to a $50,000.
Similar to an architect.
Yeah, so why isn't it a specific number? You're saying you're estimating it.
Well,
it is a percentage of the project. So if you decide you want a different scope, the fee would be a different fee based on the scope in our RFP request.
Correct.
If we...
It's...
When you say scope, what are you talking about?
We have three different proposals that were in the RFP response. There were three different project sizes. So it's based on the three different scopes that were proposed. I don't know if everyone's looked at the RFP at this point.
Building and grounds. If you want it, I'll give you a copy. It's a binder about this big with multiple projects of all the HVC upgrades. The
grounds?
Light LEDs, the water conservation measures.
All the things we talked about,
all the things that Bob Brown went over are in their RFPs.
So when this gentleman talks about scope, he's talking about
the RFP that they provided us. Right.
And we need
right.
to decide if we do any of those things, and they'll tell us it's going to save us this amount of money.
Correct.
And if it does save us that amount of money,
right,
then they're good, we're good. We don't owe them anything either.
Right.
Okay.
Actually,
correct. Is there more work to do to go from here to?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. We have a final engineer all the different options that are available to the district.
Okay.
And then we will come back and present to you investment and savings associated with each measure. Then you pick and choose what measures you decide to include in any potential project.
It's the cost of the project plus 50 grand.
It's rolled into the project, correct.
When you say rolled in, we're paying it.
Correct.
Right. Okay, so if we walk away and pick nothing, we owe nothing?
If we cannot generate a self-funded solution, you would owe nothing.
They'll be able to generate a self-funded solution.
It's the cost of the project, not plus the 50,000.
It's
so round numbers. We do an HVAC unit for $500,000.
Yeah.
We don't owe you $500,000 plus the $50,000. We owe you $500,000.
Correct.
Right.
For the HVAC.
Right.
Okay. So it's like an architect fee, like we've done.
They'll pay for that.
There's engineering.
It's like a project management fee.
I don't think that's what they said.
That is what they said.
It's rolled into the project. Correct.
No. We buy an HVAC system.
There's no fee.
And the HVAC system costs $500,000.
Correct.
Off the shelf, pick it up, $500,000. You said before is that now we're going to add $50,000 to that.
No,
we're rolling it in.
It's part. It's
already
be,
in
there. It would be part of the
$500,000
for
engineering.
So it's not
engineering a solution.
It's
not just you like pull it off the shelf.
No,
if we don't do anything, we owe the $50,000. If we move forward with any part of the plan.
To Neil's point, the engineering survey is included in that $500,000.
Yeah, see, I hear what you're saying, and I think I understand it, but we're going to owe you $50,000 either way.
Steve, well, the amount of work that they've done, like,
regardless of,
I mean, it's,
we're going to owe you $50,000 either way, right?
Well,
if we cannot develop a self-funded solution, you don't owe us anything.
But I don't know anything about it. I mean, how do I know whether you can develop a self-funded solution?
Would you like to join the Building and Grounds Committee?
To you. Please, okay?
We'll present the options to you, the investment as well as the savings associated with each measure. And if I come back to you and say I cannot develop a self-funded solution for you, you won't owe us a dime.
Okay, can I ask a question?
Sure.
When
sure.
you come back and give us these options, at that time are we liable to give you that? I mean, to pay you $50,000 if you can't give us something we need.
Correct.
Yes, sir. You're
okay.
able to get out of the proposal. If that's what you're, are you asking
yes.
that? Yes.
Okay.
So if we move forward, because I think three people said three different things.
Right.
We're, it would be signing a contract says, okay, you're going to put everything together. Give us the cost. I think what we all want to be able to see what the savings is, what it costs,
right.
what the investment is. If we move forward with any of that, we don't owe you an additional $50,000.
Right.
That's part
right.
of if it costs $500,000 right. off the shelf for HVAC unit, we pay $500,000. You consider that as part, it's not an additional fee of
right.
$50,000.
Right.
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 We don't do anything, we owe you $50,000.
To put the
and thirdly,
together.
Correct.
Right.
And if thirdly, if you come back and you say, oh crap, we can't put anything together to make you any savings.
Then there's no fee.
Then there's no fee.
Right.
Everyone's.
And like it's like this. Like they're gonna they would come in like this. When we were looking at this piece of paper before that they gave us.
Yeah.
Let's say they say, I'm just looking at something. LED lighting upgrades and controls, $155,000. That's at one school. You do it at all the schools, you're saving this. Water conservation. You do this, you save this. The bottom line is if we do those things, that those things have to be engineered. Like those things, it's not like, you know, we just say we do this and all of a sudden faucets show up in our
right.
thing. I mean, somebody
right.
has to like do something to make those faucets appear, work right, be on the right, the lighting, be on the right sensors and all the other
would
stuff.
Would it be, I guess.
That's where they'll get their money.
But to give
you
a person.
For you guys and for the board, would it be beneficial before the next meeting if people wanted to sit down with Bob Brown and with them? To go over it.
And isn't there another company involved too? Schneider?
Yeah, this was the recommendation of administration.
The administration is recommending this, I. So, that's what I'm
so essentially this vote is for $50,000.
This vote is for moving forward with everything we talked about in the Building and Grounds Committee meeting. And talking to Bob does not have the capability with his existing staff to move forward with any of this stuff without a consulting company.
Let me ask a question. If you go, let's sort of bear with me because this is not my forte, right? We buy the air conditioning units for Ramsey, okay? Because they're, as we know, they can be band-aided for a few years, but they're pretty sharp. But you're gonna go and buy a GE air conditioner, I'm just saying, okay? How do we know, or will we know, what you pay for that GE air conditioner?
It's a turnkey. So our role in this project is not necessarily just buying a GE air conditioner, right?
Uh-huh.
So our role in this is to design, engineer, procure, project manage, and commission.
Install.
And commission, install and commission.
So the
so
answer
provides
is,
you
is no.
Yeah, correct.
Okay, that's all.
So
it's no.
We
okay.
provide a single point of contact. And a three-tiered guarantee.
I'm with you on that, okay? So, again, just following up my mind, just trying to get my head around it, okay? You go and you pull off the shelf a $450,000 air conditioning thing and you put it on the roof. The $50,000 that you're gonna, that we're gonna be charged, okay, covers your, all the other things you're talking about, the engineering, the installation,
correct.
So on and so forth.
Correct.
All right. How will we as a board know what, how much that markup is?
Our
annual report. Our annual report shows what we make on an annual basis. We're
not
a publicly traded company.
On these projects.
I don't think we know that on any. I mean, if we do, if we
just,
get a roof, we
just
get a bid.
Just asking, how would we know?
Correct, Paul.
Yeah, if we're going to do that.
I mean,
we don't
like,
know what their profit is.
Like, if you get a bid for something, you don't know how much the people are making. But in general, they make 5%, I think.
Yeah, you're right,
right
about that. I guess I'm, okay.
Okay, I'm gonna ask a question.
Sure.
So what we went over tonight before this meeting, the Building and Grounds, everything that Bob Brown came up with, all these figures, none of these figures would be any good if we go with you guys. Am I correct in saying that?
No, that Bob actually got this from talking to these guys.
Okay. Well, that's what I just wanted. I didn't want him going through all that work and then...
So the next step would really be... And
firm fixed
correct
price.
Correct me if I'm wrong. Seeing, okay, if we spend $400,000 on an HVAC unit, here's how much we'll save. Or if
correct.
We spend
correct.
$32,000 in the pool for LED lights, here's what we'll save in
correct.
Electricity.
Correct.
Right.
So there are... So air
so
conditioning,
help Paul
right?
figure out...
There's
my, my reservations, just and not even reservations, is that this is a pretty big initiative. I'm not up to speed on it. Now, I know that's why you have committees, but I'm maybe a more why did you pick this outfit over Schneider? Were there three other outfits? I mean, I sort of understand the concept. What? Okay, well, they're sort of understand the concept. I just have, it's a lot of money. To
can I make a recommendation?
Do we think it would be beneficial to have Paul Brown and them sit down with any board members that have any questions?
We can do that next week. The other thing, too, that we do as part of this process, we do workshops. So we try to bring the board along in a process. We'll have you come in meetings. We'll talk about the scope. You end up choosing the scope. We talk about the savings. So there's a little bit of a training part in this as well.
How did we identify the two?
That was
their
people that
were
RFP.
Re-advertising.
RFP. And these were
the
only
two that came out.
Correct.
Was the efficiency network included on this? We had a series of meetings back on 12/1/2015 and a follow-up meeting in the library. Were they included on this?
I mean, the RFP went out.
It was out for
it was public.
And anybody
it was public.
Could reply who wanted to reply to it.
I'd have to go back to
just one.
It's not like we sent it to somebody. Anybody.
No.
Okay. We only got two back.
Okay, I'm going to ask this could be a really stupid question. All right, probably is, but you're saying over at Ramsey, from what Mr. Brown gave us, to replace the roof is $594,000. All right. Now, does that mean Mr. Brown would have to go out and hire a company if he doesn't go with you guys to do the roof that would cost us $594,000? That's a general question I'm asking. Because these are the figures that we're looking at. With
the utilization of the architect.
These were very, very rough estimates.
Yeah.
Okay.
What they're going to do is these and maybe even other things.
I know what I mean.
They're going to nail it down a little bit closer. This was just
estimates.
Very rough estimates.
Right.
That's what
I think
Bill summarized
it a little.
Pinpoint us into the exact details of what we're trying to accomplish. Like for all these, like, you know.
Perfectly sure.
Right, I mean, we're just
what
trying to...
What did you say, Mr. Short?
And is that like...
No.
I missed it.
Primarily the identification of our architect and looking at the roof, ultimately we're going out for bid on, and the specking of the product determines the price as well.
Okay.
So all of that rolls into a fee that's included within the actual purchase and installation of the roof.
Okay.
So is it... So if you guys want to meet with people, I'd say let's do that. Or if you guys have questions, because I think Bob definitely needs to be present at the next meeting for the full meeting. And then if anyone has questions that they don't think of tonight, let's get those answered prior to
mm-hmm.
next meeting. George.
Yeah, I'd rather meet with them again.
Okay.
Yeah, that's fine. The scope of this. So the next meeting, we're going to have more information about this stuff that the buildings and grounds we get reviewed today.
Right, but
we're going to start to narrow that.
Yes, but I mean, but the bottom line is, as we all know in here, I believe, we're going to do
something.
Of that stuff.
We
have to do some of it,
yeah.
Or else we're not going to, our school's going to fall
down.
So we have to do some of that stuff.
Yeah.
So the bottom line is, they're going to give us a list of all of those things and maybe more, and we can say, all right, we want to do that one, that one, and that one. And They'll manage the process of doing that, and they're going to tell us what we're going to save by doing that. Is something that you were asking for before.
Yeah, I think
if you get a new new doors
in
the building, we're going to save whatever in our energy bill.
I understand.
That's the biggest part.
And guarantee the savings. So
and
the
guarantee
savings
the savings.
Not on an annual basis. We have to write a check.
So the total of all of those things that we talked about was...
11.5.
Immediate 2.3.
2.3.
So over the course of the next month or two, we're going to be focusing on the 2.3. What you said, 2.3.
Yes.
What do we want in the 2.3?
Right.
We want it all.
We may not.
And also
because,
the cost
you know,
of a new building.
We decide
building
to build
as well.
A new school, for instance.
Yeah.
Right.
One of them's going to drop off, and then it's going to.
Okay.
Balance
we'll
however it
down
balances
on square
Paul,
footage, classroom size. How does this help you as far as financing, looking at costs, looking at budgeting for next year?
Well, I mean, one of the things with this is going to be in terms of what scope of project. For instance, some of those we discussed, we can self-fund those. So, I mean, you know, not incurring additional debt is one area for that. But, I mean, really it's just taking a look at it. What's being proposed and again, which direction we decide to go.
But the savings would be beneficial to see.
Well, if there's savings that, and I'll, you know, let's just say we're going to do four projects that they propose.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if maybe they affect four different buildings, we could reduce, if they basically come back and say, look, you can save $50,000 in electricity. If we can actually reduce that line item in the budget by that amount, then sure.
Right.
I mean, that helps in terms of budget relief.
Into the project.
And just for everybody's knowledge, and I think that it's been said several times, they guarantee you, if they tell you you're going to save, if you do this, you're going to save $50,000, you're going to save $50,000 or else they're going to write you a check for $50,000. So you're going to save the $50,000 if you do it. If you do it, you're going to save the money because it's guaranteed. They're guaranteeing.
Right. Is there a time period to this contract, or is it just limited to the dollar, the $50,000, and then we pick and choose?
I think it's an engagement.
Like if we go over 4 years as opposed to doing everything at once, is that
yeah.
That's up to you. Quite honestly, it's up to the school district.
So there's not another $50,000 fee or
no.
We've had clients that have performed a phase one this year on certain facilities, and next year they'll do a phase two in different facilities.
Okay. Well, I think if we're doing a 5 year or 6 year,
I think part of the whole thing is the first thing they're going to do is, okay, Bob came up with this, and with help from whomever he talked to, I'm sure he talked to all these people, but you know, Bob says, switchgear and electrical main distribution panel replacement, $230,000. Well, these guys may or may not come back and say, hey, you know what, that's going to last another year, or that may last five more years, don't change it yet. Or, you know, I don't, you know what I mean? That's another thing they're going to tell us is, how long is all this stuff really going to last? Because I know these are, for the most part, Bob's recommendations in some regard. But maybe some of these ones that he has for next year need to move to this year. And they're going to tell us the useful life of every single thing in our district, basically. Every building.
Is that an accurate statement?
Yeah.
So you're gonna have a long-term capital improvement plan when we're done. So whether you do it now or 5 or 10 years, at least you'll know what you need to do.
Yeah. And you'll know that this building's done in 2023.
So the payback, I'm sorry.
Go ahead, I'm sorry.
So the payback, is that a time-specific payback? In other words, just using that, we're gonna invest $300,000, and it's going to save us. Your some estimate is that over 2 years, 10 years.
We'll show you that.
We'll show you on an annual basis. We'll show you aggregate over whatever that term may be.
And at the end of the day, you'll be able to pick which ones you want. You know, we're not telling you what you need to do. We're showing you the options.
Right.
Would you guys be able to talk with George after this, if anyone else has
questions
about setting up a time to meet?
You bet.
So you're going to set a meeting up.
Well, I think if anyone's interested, and probably have Bob Brown there as well.
I'll set up a date, time,
I'm
and invite everyone
in
that
hearing more.
Okay.
Sure.
Okay.
If it's five or more board members, we would have to be open to the public, which is not a problem, but we just need to advertise. So if you guys are interested, just let Bill know.
I am.
And that way he can establish any advertising that needs to be done.
Great. Thank you.
Fair.
Appreciate it.
Right. Any other questions on that one? All right. That concludes administrative resolutions. We'll move on to Section G, resolutions presented by board members. Do we have any resolutions presented by board members? One more time. Do we have any resolutions by board members?
Sorry.
All right. Seeing none, we'll move on to comments from residents on non-agenda items. So would anyone like to address?
Go ahead.
You want to stand up at the mic?
You kept the missile on a school night?
John's gonna buy you lunch.
Hello, my name's Alex Portis. As you all know, I was on the Kids Baking Championship season 2 back in January, and I'm going to be back on tomorrow night at 8 o'clock on the Food Network.
Awesome.
On my TV.
I just wanted to like tell about that maybe and get around the school. And one idea that me and my mom had was like maybe the school could get together, like get something together where we could like premiere the show like in an auditorium somewhere, and then we'd have like a place where we'd sell desserts, and then because we were watching on the news one day where kids who didn't have enough money to get lunch, like they wouldn't be able to get lunch, so all the money raised from that would go to those kids who don't have enough money for lunch. So
Alex, is this tomorrow you said that you're going to be on?
Yes.
So we would have to get everything together by tomorrow?
No, we could do it like this weekend or next weekend.
So we could get a recording. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
How old are you, Alex?
I'm 13.
Nicely done.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So what are you making for us?
I would...
You made cupcakes for the spaghetti dinner?
Yes.
They were very good. Thank you.
I didn't receive one of those, Alex. Well, any
chance
I could
come.
Well, now with this awesome idea of Alex, you can donate money and help kids out in the district too.
All right, so Mr. Student Board, Mr. Chaky and I are going to go ahead and we're going to try to brainstorm how we might be able to feature, you know, maybe a snippet, morning announcements, or we'll brainstorm ways to help feature Alex's good.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, I think that's awesome. In the meantime, also, could we send out a Skyward blast to notify everyone that we'll be on tomorrow?
And it will also be repeated on Saturday, so the blast should say that, you know, give the audience two chances to watch it. Okay?
Do we have?
Do you know the time for Saturday?
I was just about
Saturday
to ask the time.
Saturday at 3 o'clock p.m.
And what time tomorrow?
Tomorrow at 8.
Tomorrow at 8. Network.
What did you make?
Some
can't people
say.
Might not be.
I like it. Teasing.
I'll look it up on like Xfinity or whatever the.
Okay, so we can send out an email to all.
Yep.
Of the district, letting them know that when it will air, and then we can.
It will be on
Mr.
both
Mr. Ritter and Mr. Jacob will work on something to.
And Verizon.
Yeah. Good job.
I have one question. Alex.
A few more questions. For you.
Wait a minute. Alex is essentially contractually prohibited from discussing.
That's true.
George.
Alex, at this point, you signed an autograph with my grandson's photo. He appreciated immensely because he watches you all come. I appreciate that.
You're welcome.
And board members, do you know that Alex gives speeches? He was down at the Monroeville Convention Center, was it last week?
Mm-hmm. We're celebrating Monroeville.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'll take an autograph cupcake.
Well, I think your accomplishments are awesome, but I think your idea to raise money and to donate is outstanding.
Yes.
Yeah, that's.
Let us know how we can help, okay?
Awesome.
Okay.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank
Alex.
You very much, Alex.
Thank you. Go home and do your homework.
Stay home.
Sorry, he has a bad time.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Good night.
Have a good night.
Thank you, you too. Do we have any other, I don't think you're going to top it, but do we have any other residents that would like to address the board this evening? Seeing none, we will move on to reports. Mrs. Cronk.
Nothing at this time, thank you.
Very good. Mr. Schott.
Nothing further, thank you.
Dr. Chaky.
Nothing at this time.
It's nicely done.
I always have something to say. Real quick here, next Monday we do have our professional development for our teaching staff. A number of activities will occur wrapped around curriculum, instruction, and assessment. Including various workshops, but I would also like to highlight the efforts of Mark Wallace. We have been able to bring in a noted historian by the name of Dr. Timothy Naftali. Those of you who are social studies history geeks like myself, as a former social studies teacher in my prior life, I have watched the CNN network series, the 60s, 70s, and 80s. And if you happen to view those, and there's probably seven or eight different shows within each series, Dr. Naftali has been the narrator and the individual who was brought in on those historical features. So he will be here at Gateway next Monday as part of the professional development with our social studies teachers. There will be teachers from other area school districts as well as our students who will be attending as well. So I invite the board to
that. Who put this together?
Myself and Mark Wallace.
It's a great idea. Great idea.
Yeah, Mr. Short.
That is all.
Very good. We'll move on to board reports, and we'll start with Mr. O'Donnell.
Nothing at this time.
Very good. Mrs. Dunn.
I would like to thank Mr. Ulowitz and Mrs. Mathis for the STEAM program presentation today. It was really great to see everything that's happening with Mossside Middle School and their STEAM program. And also Kylie Edwards and Perry Mafuglo, they both did an excellent job at presenting. And also congratulations again to Alex Portis for going on another championship, baking championship show at 8 o'clock and at 3 on Saturday. And that's all I have.
Great stuff, Mr. Lapsovich.
Nothing this evening.
Mrs. Warning?
Yes, I want to welcome Mr. Chaikin because he took off last
time. Oh, that's right.
He left at midnight.
So thank you for staying.
He had a midnight
drink. Welcome to Gateway.
He was contractually obligated to leave.
I told him the text messages I received on the way home at midnight wondering if Dennis was going to appear tomorrow.
They said he wouldn't be back, but he's back. So, okay, but welcome to Gateway. Glad you're here. Also, the website, I believe, is close to being done.
We are almost there. I would like to invite some parents, some board members in to view the, if you want to say, the debut of this and provide some feedback. Before we go live. So we are, it's exciting. I heard that you saw a preview of it, and it's the wow factor we've been looking for.
Yes, it is. Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. And I want to thank Mr. Reese and Mr. Stanford for the plaques for our new assistant superintendents. They are all matching now. Thank you. And thank you, Mrs. Mathis and Mr. Ulowitz and the students for the STEAM presentation. Also, I've been reading, there's a lot in the papers lately about the Narcan that's coming into schools, and I just didn't know if we had anything any farther on that, Mr. Short.
I'm sorry.
Yes, I will. I have an update for that.
Okay. Well. All right. Thank you. Okay. We did get the bell back at last Friday's game from Penn Trafford, so now the bell is currently here until next year. Gateway won. This Thursday, the high school students, because we don't have a homecoming parade anymore, they do have a carnival that they will set up in the
parking lot right here, adjacent to the maintenance building.
Correct, and there will be a bonfire there also Thursday
evening. Very big bonfire. Yes.
Very big bonfire, yes. And Friday is the homecoming game, so hopefully there's a lot of people. I don't know if Mr. Ross will be here by then, but we are playing Plum.
He will be here on Monday.
Okay.
Oh, 18th. We got released a week early. Coming. How about that?
Well, no, the 18th. It's a week.
Okay,
early.
I'm sorry.
Sorry.
You got me upset.
They need a little bit of transition time.
And then the homecoming dance is Saturday, so I wish everyone a good time. Be safe. And finally, we got our pens. Thank you, Mr. Schott, for giving us the pens. And that's it.
Very good. Thank you, Mrs. Warren.
Mr. Warren. Congratulations to Alex and to our STEAM teachers and our STEAM kids that were here tonight. Great job. Hats off to them. That's it.
Mr. Ritter.
Sure. Two things. Miko Brown said that the meetings have not been broadcast according to the regular schedule, and there's some equipment that needs to be taken care of. So he's looking into a different way, perhaps, to broadcast it in an ungoverned way. That is, put a DV out there and just let it continually loop rather than to broadcast it at the time selected. So he's working on that. We apologize to the folks in the listening public that they aren't able to listen to it. You could also go to the library and get DVDs of the meetings if you wanted. Now, number two, last month I was in Baltimore at a HL7 working group meeting. This is a worldwide standards development organization. And I hosted an event, a webinar, and had CMS, that's the Center for Medicare and Medicaid Services, ONC, that's the Office of the National Coordinator, the National Association of School Nurses, a certifying organization, all come together, scratch their heads and ask the question, is there something a standards development organization can do to help the school nurses do their jobs a little bit better, making things easier for them? So we're going to, the next step in this is to put together a meeting through HIMSS, that's the Health Information Management System Society, and promote it in Western, Central, and Eastern Pennsylvania. And then if we have good results there, take it to the state legislature, that's the Pennsylvania State Legislature, toss the idea to them and see whether they might want to pass some legislation, perhaps fund an initiative to study the question and perhaps make it easier for the school nurses to keep our kids safe, well, and in school. Okay? So that's my report.
Very good. Thank you, Mr. Ritter. Mrs. Ritchie.
No, I just want to reiterate what my colleague said about seeing the STEAM presentation by Mrs. Mattis and Mr. Yulowitz and hearing Kylie and Perry speak and even Alex. These are all really fine students. And these are the kind of kids that really make us proud to be Gateway. And they exemplify that spirit of excellence that we hope all of our kids, you know, strive to achieve. So kudos to all of them.
Thank you very much. Mr. Nolan.
Nothing tonight. Thank you, though.
You sure?
Yes.
Thank you. I just have a few things. I guess, first of all, next Monday, anyone that is able to come out for Dr. Naftali, that is awesome. I do watch the CNN, even though I'm not a big fan. The series, the 60s, 70s, 80s, is awesome. Yeah. So, fortunately, I'll be in the Keys, but anyone who is able to attend, I highly recommend attending. To the students who came, presented for STEAM, and Alex, I mean, what better kids can you ask to come and represent the district? I was honestly blown away by how well-spoken they were, and I was glad, actually, that they had clarified that the students actually wrote those speeches. I mean, they were amazing. To think of how young they were and how well-spoken they were. I mean, I know when I first started on here, I sometimes got nervous speaking, and for them to come and present to a room full of adults was absolutely amazing. So congratulations to everything they've done through STEAM and Alex and his personal accomplishments, and then to come here and offer a way to support other students at Gateway that are in need is just extraordinary. So congratulations and thank you to all of them and also all teachers involved there. Val had brought up the Narcan policy, and we will have a policy committee meeting, so just members on the policy committee, along with all administrators, building administrators, and central on October 19th. And that time is to be determined in the morning, and Mr. Short will send out an email there. We will be going over the Narcan policy, and I also want to report, I've now had three people from, just another one was this past week, I've had three students from my graduating class alone who have passed away, unfortunately, due to overdoses. All once they were out of the district, but that's three people that are 25, 26 years old. Parents out there, guardians, teachers, be nebby, I know it's a Pittsburgh word, but see what they're doing. You know, students might get mad at you, kids might get mad at you, okay. But I mean, that's huge. So my thoughts and prayers, I won't mention his name, but are with another student in my class, his family. So please, we will definitely be addressing that. We have heard back from the physician. We have the policy that we will be reviewing in the policy meeting, and hopefully the board will look to approve that. Fortunately, we haven't had any problems in the schools, but I think if there's a tool available that can help anyone in any way, we should have all tools available in the school. So we will be working on that.
Our meeting on Monday the 10th as part of their workshop.
Correct.
And so this little widget that we're attempting to create would take into account behavioral health, substance abuse, mental health, a lot of the aspects that are very difficult for nurses to tackle.
Yeah, so we'll be looking at everything in its totality, but as far as the Narcan that you brought up, we'll definitely go over that on the 19th, and hopefully we will get that approved right away. So, homecoming, I believe they've been doing it for 2 years now. The students, the teachers do an amazing job over there. If you haven't come, you'll see the bonfire literally from miles away. It's incredible how big of a fire they built. I mean, teachers are volunteering. I know the previous years they've done dump tanks. They've done a lot of different creative ways to raise money, and they do a great job at raising money that was shown by two of the teachers actually as well, for the Connellsville donation. So, I mean, it was shown by Alex here today, it's shown by our teachers and staff, our students. They go above and beyond as far as raising money and helping others, and that's truly refreshing to see in this world today. So everyone going to homecoming dance, please be safe. And that is all that I have. With that, I will seek motion for adjournment.
So moved.
Do we have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Seeing none, we are adjourned. Thank you.
I just need to have a few things real quick.
We have not yet.